Salam olahraga Horas, Sobat Pora. Pelaksanaan F1 Power Boat Danau Toba 2024 sukses digelar dengan menghadirkan setidaknya 18 pebalap dari 10 negara peserta yang telah menjajal sirkuit yang dikenal unik dan memiliki kesulitan tersendiri dibandingkan sirkuit lain di dunia. Kompetisi F1 Power Boat Series Danau Toba tahun ini dimenangkan oleh tim Sarjah dengan balapnya yang bernama Rusty Wyatt. Yang uniknya, ini merupakan penampilan perdananya di F1 Power Boat sekaligus menjadi kemenangan pertamanya semenjak ia bergabung di tim Sarjah.
Penyelenggaraan F1 Power Boat 2024 Danau Toba untuk yang kedua kalinya kembali berjalan lancar dan sukses. Balapan F1 Power Boat seri Danau Toba 2024 kali ini dimenangkan oleh tim Sarjah dengan pembalap atas nama Rusty Wyatt. Pada seri balapan Danau Toba tahun ini, tim Sarjah membawa dua pembalapnya atas nama Philip Roms dan juga Rusty Wyatt. Ada hal yang unik dari kemenangan tim Sarjah kali ini. Rusty Wyatt adalah pembalap Kanada yang menjadi pembalap baru di tim Sarjah untuk kejuaraan dunia F1 H2O UIM 2024 di bawah manajemen Scott Gilman. Atraksinya di F1 Power Boat Danau Toba 2024 merupakan penampilan perdananya di seri F1 H2O. Berasal dari Innisfil di Ontario, Wyatt telah berkompetisi di American Power Boat Competition dengan perahu Crystal Clear Rusty Wyatt Racing dan memenangkan Lake Havasu Classic 2022. Sebagai teknisi elevator, dia adalah Rookie of the Year dari Federasi Perahu Kanada dalam kategori T850. Pada tahun 2012 dan merupakan juara High Point pada tahun 2013 dan 2015. Menjadi rookie top di Tour Super League pada tahun 2016, ia lulus di balap Formula 2 sebelum akhirnya menembus kelas teratas power boating di Amerika Serikat. Kemenangannya di Indonesia memberikan kesan tersendiri baginya.
Hanging out in Lake Toba, Indonesia has been very, very beautiful. I'm a rookie to this series, but I got lots of time on in a boat like this under my belt. So it was, we were coming in here very solid, but you try your best to win every race and all that. But you know, Lake Toba is a very unique spot, and we got lucky with our last lap finish to seal the deal for the win. Yeah, Lake Toba has a very technical, unique course. We don't usually run a course with this many turn buoys, so it makes it that much more exciting for the fans. And I think on our parade lap when we were running around the shoreline and seeing how many people were on the shore, it warmed my heart up pretty well. I was really, really happy seeing how many people made it out to this event. Yeah, well, of course a special moment is winning. You know, winning any of these races is very, very tricky. But I went swimming in Lake Toba for the very first day I was here. That was nice. I really enjoyed that. And again, I just the people, the amount of love you get around here, everybody just enjoys it so much. I think it's such a big part to this community. And I can only imagine what everybody else is saying around here. There's just a lot going on in a weekend. It's so cool. It's so, so cool to see. Yeah, we were talking about that in some of the press conferences about an Indonesian driver possibly in the future. So we were kind of thinking like, how could we train a driver or maybe get a team started and all that. You know, it all comes down from the beginning of these European tours or the European side. They do a lot of F4, it's called Formula 4 instead of the Formula 1. A lot of guys go from Formula 4, Formula 2, and then into Formula 1. Or a lot of, so there's been many talents coming from Formula 4 right into Formula 1. So I think that's your best. Aquabike, I haven't really played with too much aquabike, so I don't really know a whole lot to be honest about that. But I'm sure there's a team that would coach somebody through that. And, you know, you get a little bit of a smaller vessel to train on and kind of go from there.
Dari Balige, Sumatera Utara, Pora TV melaporkan.